Hello everyone, welcome at the Academy on Air Accelerating Retail session. My name is Catharine de Vlieg and I work as the EMEA Retail Lead. I'm very excited today to talk about how you can grow your sales with your advertisers during these dynamic times as well as during the peak season. I'm here not alone. I'm here together with my colleague Justin, who will introduce himself as well.
Thank you, Katerina, for the introduction. Hi, everyone. My name is Justin, and I am a strategic agency consultant. So I consult for some of the most digitally advanced marketing agencies in the UK, such as yourselves. And I also represent the agency perspective internally in our retail task force. So I'm very excited to kind of share a lot of the learnings that I take partnering with agencies and clients throughout EMEA and helping bring those learnings to you guys to make sure that we're using the best solutions possible moving forward.
In case you have any questions, please feel free to ask them in the comment button under the video. We will make sure to answer these live. Today, we're going to discuss the trends that we have been seeing within EMEA during these dynamic times and how you can grow the sales of your advertisers during the dynamic times as well as during the peak season. We will discuss what kind of strategic pillars you can utilize in order to increase the performance of your advertisers, as well as be a true business partner to them. Tomorrow, we will have another session where we will deep dive into the main challenges that you called out that you're facing with smart shopping campaigns. Thanks so much for everyone who filled in the pre-survey and gave us the main challenges that you are facing. I would like to invite my colleague Justin, who's going to talk you through all the trends that he has been seeing during these dynamic times.
So the reason we're here today, guys, is to talk a little bit about smart shopping and how we can really use it to kind of drive your goals around maximizing sales. At a very high level, what we see across the industry or various verticals is that smart shopping drives 30% more volume in sales versus standard shopping. And around times of peak, whether that be Black Friday or Cyber Week or the individual peaks within your verticals, we see an additional percentage points, up to 4 percentage points there as well. So it's a really good solution here that kind of drives that performance that you and your clients are looking for. Now, to make this a bit more relatable, I want to share with you guys a success story from one of our partnered agencies, Recruiting Marketing, and their top client, magazines.com. By implementing smart shopping and some of the best practices that we're going to discuss today, we're able to see a 180% increase in revenue over a very important peak period between Thanksgiving and Black Friday for this client. But not only that, we're able to see sustainable long-term growth with 95% increase in sales over the whole fiscal year. Now, results like this with smart shopping have been very prominent in the past, but now it's a bit more relevant than ever as we're seeing a lot of influences from COVID and consumer behavior and purchasing patterns. That not just involves, you know, where they're buying and what they're purchasing, but also how they're purchasing and how that research phase is defined. We're seeing a lot of people search for things that they wouldn't normally search for or they haven't searched for before. Of course, some of the ones that we may think from our own personal experience is a lot of people getting involved in DIY, home and gardening, cooking. And a lot of these trends don't just involve what people are searching for, but how they've been searching for it. So using solutions like smart shopping allow us to kind of cover the whole consumer journey and making sure we're showing up when needed. Now, that's not to say that once this period of time and uncertainty is over, that things will go back to the way they were before. What we've found from various Ipsos studies is that consumer behavior patterns are going to be everlasting after this period of time. And so using a product like smart shopping that really accounts for this uncertainty and the volatility, which we'll speak to more in this presentation, is more crucial now than ever. So these changing behavioral shifts actually provide a really great opportunity for our advertisers, our clients, and brands to really show up in this space. What we actually see from one of the more recent Ipsos studies is that about between 20 and 50% of consumers in the EMEA have shopped with a retailer that was new to them. So this was someone that they had never really engaged with prior to COVID-19. And this is showing us a few things. As I said in the last slide, not only are people researching more and engaged more in this research phase, but they also have a more or an increased willingness to engage and purchase from brands that are new to them. So the question is, how do we become one of those new brands or help our clients that we partner with become one of those new brands that potential customers want to engage with? So again, one point that I really want to make clear is that it's not just that individuals are open to purchasing from new brands, but they're also really emphasizing that research phase before purchasing because now they have more comfortability and an interest in researching brands online that they might not have been able to do so in store or don't feel comfortable about doing in store at this point in time. And what we see is that about 80% of individuals during this research phase are switching between search and video and these upper funnel type of products. So it's not all about just trying to capture that intent, but it's about showing up during that research phase. From my own personal examples working with agencies and clients, we know that a lot of potential customers are looking for videos around reviews or how-to videos around products. So making sure that we're up there at the upper funnel and that we're showing up and capturing this is essential. And again, as Google, we want to make sure that we're partnering with you here. We have 1 billion active users on almost all of our platforms. And so if we can make sure we're using products such as smart shopping that show up across this funnel, we can really capture that potential. So I guess the big question is why now? And why are we talking about smart shopping today for you guys to bring value to your clients? I think products like this, ones that are able to not only identify those pockets of opportunity, but also use machine learning to making sure we're capitalizing on those areas of performance, is really what makes you guys as an agency a true business partner for your clients. It's being able to understand these type of products, but also implementing best practices to make sure that they're driving that type of performance. Now, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna hand over to Katerina, who's really gonna help you guys understand this and break down what do these best practices look like and how can we drive that strategic value as a partner to our clients.
Thank you so much, Justin, for sharing these trends with us. And of course, I would love to share a little bit more detail on how Smart Shopping Campaigns is able to capture the fluctuations in demand and can help you grow the businesses of your advertisers. First of all, Smart Shopping Campaigns is able to acquire both new customers as well as ensure that your advertisers are able to acquire their high-value customers as well. So why is it so important to acquire these new customers, especially during times like this? As Justin mentioned before, we have seen that 20 to 50% of consumers now purchasing something online within EMEA are actually purchasing something from a brand they have never bought from before. So you have a unique opportunity to help your advertisers acquire these new consumers. As well as with retaining the high value consumers, you have a unique opportunity to increase the profitability of your advertisers. Because we have seen that if you increase the retention rate of your advertisers by just 5%, you have the opportunity to increase their profitability between 25 and 95%. So let's discuss how smart shopping campaigns can help you find the right user for your advertiser. So first of all, we've talked about that smart shopping campaigns is able to acquire both new customers as well as acquire those high value returning customers in order to get a more loyal customer base for your advertisers. In terms of the new customers, we're able to acquire customers who, one, are searching for the products of your advertisers, as well as people who have shown interest in the products of your advertisers, but have not particularly searched for it yet. So imagine, we identify that someone is a new mom because they have been watching a lot of YouTube videos about what to do when you're a new mom. We have seen that they visited a lot of new mom blogs online, and we have that understanding that that's their interest. And your advertiser is selling baby clothes. So we will show ads to that new mom in order to make sure that you can acquire a new customer base for your advertiser. As well as it's very important to create a more loyal customer base. As I mentioned before, increasing that retention rate of your advertiser can increase the profitability of your advertiser. So we will also make sure to focus on those repeat purchases of your high-value customers. Smart shopping campaigns show ads at scale. It shows ads across search, display, Gmail, as well as YouTube. In this way, we're able to capture clients wherever they are on the Google network and make sure that they purchase something at your advertiser's website in order for you to grow the sales for your clients. In the next section, we will discuss four main pillars on how you can add strategic value to your advertisers and be a true business partner to them. First of all, Smart Shopping Campaigns not only is able to utilize Google Signal data, but is also able to utilize the first-party data of the retailer itself. So you can give strategic advice on what kind of first-party data your retailer should start collecting. And then you can help them to make the connection between the data they collected and add it to the smart shopping campaigns in order to drive true business impact for them. So think about adding their high-value customers in a customer match list, or think about adding all the consumers who purchase something over a certain value. The second pillar that we're going to discuss is to make sure that the campaign structure of the smart shopping campaigns is aligned with the business goal of your advertiser. So there are different campaign structures that we advise depending on the business goal of the advertiser. Think about whether they want to increase their revenue or whether they want to increase their profitability. In the session tomorrow, we will go into a little bit more detail on how you can set up the different campaign structures and align that to the business goal of your advertiser. But this again is a strong way to really be a true business partner to your advertiser and really add strategic value. We already see strong results of advertisers who use this new acquisition tool. IT Cosmetics is an example of an advertiser who used this new acquisition tool to acquire new consumers. From the moment that they activated this, they saw a 188% increase in revenue from their core campaign. Additionally, they saw a 65% increase in overall ROAS from their core campaign. And I want to recommend to implement this new acquisition tool in case you want to acquire new customers, as well as want to have an understanding what percentage of the sales came from new customers versus what percentage of the sales came from returning customers. We have discussed two strategic pillars now. First of all, is ensuring that you give strategic advice on what first-party data your advertisers should start collecting and enrich the smart shopping campaign with this first-party data. Secondly, is to make sure that the campaign structure is aligned to the business goal of your advertiser. And thirdly, is to ensure that there is operational excellence. So for this, think about having a strong feed health, having the right creatives added to the campaign, having the right product images, etc. You can add a lot of additional information to the feed in order to make the system smarter, set up the campaign structure in such a way that you can steer towards that data, as well as you can give them a lot of interesting insights afterwards. So think about adding information such as stock levels and setting up campaign structure based on the stock levels of your advertiser. Or think about adding margin data to the feed so that you're able to steer towards profitability. Additionally, you also then have the opportunity to provide a lot of interesting insights to your advertiser by adding this information to the feed. And I will discuss this in the next pillar, which is coming right now. And this brings me to the fourth pillar, being a true business partner to your advertiser by providing them with strategic insights. As I just mentioned, when you add a lot of interesting information to the data feed of your advertiser, such as margin data, stock levels, etc., you're able to show them whether the products which are high in stock are being sold, or you're able to show them the difference between the high margin categories products as well as the low category products. Additionally, you can really give them advice on which products they should have in stock because there's an increase in demand right now. We're going to discuss two main reports today. First of all, we're going to discuss the shopping report. And secondly, we're going to discuss the bestseller report. The shopping report you can find at reports, predefined reports, and then shopping. Here you can find a lot of interesting insights for your advertiser. So for example, here you can see that there was an increase in demand for slippers. And that makes a lot of sense. We're all working from home. We want to be comfortable. So most likely we're not going to buy high heels, but we're going to buy some slippers. So it's important that you provide that advice to your advertisers and ensure that they have this in stock. Additionally, here, you can filter on the custom labels that you have been created. So in case you have created custom labels on, for example, stock levels, margin level, products which are in sale, you're able to filter on this and show your advertiser how these different categories are performing. So loads of interesting insights that you can get from this report, and it ensures that you can be a true business partner to your advertisers. The bestseller report ensures that you are able to see what the best-selling products are on shopping per country, per category. And this is, of course, very interesting because in this way, you're able to give strategic advice on what kind of products are high in demand at the moment, are selling well, and should also be added to the inventory of your advertiser. So these were the four main pillars that you can utilize to be a true business partner to your advertiser and add strategic value to your advertisers by utilizing smart shopping campaigns. So in conclusion, smart shopping campaign is the best solution to capture the fluctuations in demand during these dynamic times, as well as during peak moments. As an agency, you can add a lot of strategic value by adding, first of all, first-party data to the smart shopping campaigns and giving advice on what kind of data your advertisers should start collecting. Secondly, the way the campaign structure is set up makes a lot of difference in terms of the performance. So you can set up the campaign structure in such a way that it drives the business goal of your advertiser. Thirdly, operational excellence is key. And especially the feed health is very important. And think about what kind of additional information you can add here to provide your advertiser with more insights, as well as to set up a better campaign structure for your advertiser. So as I mentioned, think about adding margin data, think about adding stock level data, etc. And the last pillar is ensuring that you really leverage the shopping report as well as the bestseller report to provide all the interesting insights that your advertiser might ask for. Thank you so much for watching this section. I hope it was useful to you. And please feel free to watch the session tomorrow as well, where we go into a little bit more detail on the main challenges that you are facing with smart shopping campaigns, as well as best practices in setup of smart shopping campaigns. Please also have a look at the top of your page where you can find resources of more videos as well as additional interesting materials. Also, please take a moment to fill in the survey on the right-hand side of your screen. We will use this survey to create more relevant trainings for you in the coming months. And last but not least, depending on where you are in the world, you might find some additional videos on the website. So please have a look at it and watch this video at your own time. Thank you so much for attending this session, and I wish you all an amazing day.